Hey, so we might as well start this part two. I kind of have a lot of projects going on right now. I'm waiting for my braids and gloves that have been ordered. I'm just waiting for them to be made and come in. Still need to order a rangefinder. The guy said he was going to be doing the run in January. It's now mid-February and it still hasn't happened, but you know, you can't rush these things, I guess. I need to get jetpack decals, knee strapping, that's easy. A new shelter half. There's one online that I can buy. I get paid Friday, so I might try to buy that on Friday, or maybe take a ride. There's an Army Navy store down at the beach, down at the shore. I might just take a ride there this weekend. I have to build the gauntlets. I wanted to do a little work on the inside of the knees, just to make them stronger. I have to, once I'm ready with the gauntlets, tighten up the biceps. That's some sewing on the flight suit. Strip the helmet, which I'm going to talk about in a second, and magnet the ears, which I'll also talk about. I need to paint the jetpack, the helmet, the blaster. It's a Hasbro blaster. Don't know if I need to weather the suit at all. I will need to weather the gloves when they come. I do need to weather the girth belt, and the shelter half will have to be done. And then assemble the braids onto the flight suit, make sure my knees are good to go. I need to put holes in the back of the flak vest to accommodate for the straps on the jetpack. Obviously helmet, gauntlets, shelter half. What's done, basically, the boots. Having a discussion online right now about the spats. They might need some weathering. They might need to be remade completely, who knows. We're trying to find out that now. The ammo belt and pouches are... Ammo belt's done, the pouches just need to be weathered because I remade the two bags. Armor's good to go. Basically the vest and neck seal's good to go other than the holes in the back, and my shin tools are done. So this helmet is a Sith Planet helmet. I believe it to be, and I think it's a FHP2 or FPH2, Fet Pride H2, whatever that is. And the reason I say that is someone did a repaint of one of these and he was talking about Sith Planet and stuff, and I'm looking at the helmet, I'm looking at the paint going, that looks exactly like mine. You can tell right from the damage right away that this is bad. It looks, actually I know, he used three different colored rattle can spray paints and then topically put on the silver and gray on the top. That's not anywhere close to accurate. It does have the Casio like inside in there. If it's ugly, I guess I can order the one. I think it's a Fet stencil or something, or Fet, you know, that website. And you just attach it right here, so that's an option. I'm not really sure if I want to do that yet. But this has to get all stripped. Paint is garbage. Here are the ears. They are some kind of cast. I think these will work fine. I want to put magnets in here to attach this. I'm just noticing that this is really thin, so these are going to have to be some tiny little magnets that fit inside here. There are already like three little tiny holes kind of already drilled in there, like little recesses. So if I can stick something inside there and put the stronger magnet on this side, there's a lot more material here. Probably only needs one or two, like one in each. Maybe one up here, one down here. I should just hold it in. All the hardware that it came with, I don't know if that's original or if he put that on. They stick out quite a bit inside, but there's a lot of room in there, so I guess this is the before shot of this without anything on it. I was lucky with the jetpack where I was just able to use sandpaper and everything came off. I'm gonna guess that I can do the same here. There was like not even primer on the jetpack. I'll bet you there's not even primer on this either. So I think just with sandpaper it's gonna come right off. It has the Gordon right in there. The holes do not go all the way through. I'm gonna look at some pictures. I think those holes might have to go all the way through. If so, I'll just drill them out, not a problem. Looks like I can get through there. I just have to have a drill bit that's tiny enough. So the start of the sanding.